to it, Chris. Okay, Aries, here we go with your March 21st through the 28th reading. I, of course, am Rachel Stebbins, maybe, a.k.a. Villagio Strega, if you'd like to follow me on Facebook, or you can message me there. I'm also on TikTok and Instagram now. Looks like this one wants to come out. Okay. It looks like where you're doing your challenge, your advice, your potential outcome, Aries, but I'll clarify that up for you. And I'll see what else Spirit wants you to know in route to things here. It's a fan, Snowy, relax. Okay, so first card out, bottom of the deck is Four of Wands, energy, beautiful. First card out, though, is the World. There's a completion of a cycle of sorts here, Aries. There's some sort of end of a dance, as it were, where, guess what? When this ends, you've mastered something. You've become more mature on a situation or challenge aspect of your life here, Aries. And now you are ready to birth something new. Now it's back to the beginning. The beginning of the hero's journey is once again about to occur. But recognizing something's over is a huge part of that as well. And I say recognizing, there may be some relationship stuff going on here as well, because you've also got the High Priestess energy that's using your intuition in a situation. Aries, going with your gut feeling, balancing that knowledge, that wisdom, plus what your intuitive self is saying, right? She's the recorder. She's the keeper of knowledge, that high universal energy, divine feminine keeper of secrets that are illuminated, moon energy for sure. So we know that it's using your intuition on a situation. That's your advice. Go with your gut. Also, we've got three major arcanas out here for this week's reading. And wow, so it's very, very powerful week for you, Aries, especially when it comes to something ending, using your intuition, and making a big decision. You've got the Lover's card energy for your potential outcome. Now, while this can be beautiful soulmate energy, yes, twin flame even, it's not without its hardships, okay? It's not without, its share of ups and downs too. In fact, soulmate energy can be one of the toughest energies to deal with, because there's some deep, profound things going on in soulmate energy. Nonetheless, it is a profound choice you are going to have to make this week, dear Aries. So bear that in mind. Again, use your intuition. Recognize when something's come to an end and when something new is beginning as well within that ending. Four of Wands, of course, was the bottom of the deck. That's celebration and anticipation of change, right? It's not quite there yet. The change hasn't quite happened yet, but you're celebrating nonetheless. So let's see what's going on for Aries. Clarify that World card energy for me, please. Well, for Aries. Okay, Seven of Pentacles it is. Seven of Pentacles. Let's see. Seven of Pentacles is you working hard. You're doing that 9 to 5. Do I feel like this is job loss? No, but I feel like there's some sort of payoff or even an advancement or something else in the mix here, where it's kind of like you're wondering when things are going to finally pay off, is really the Seven of Cards energy, the reward for all your hard work. Yes, rewards, I feel like rewards are headed your way. As something ends, something new is going to begin, or a decision you make, again, going with your gut. Let's see what that High Priestess energy is about, too. Hello, Icarus. And Aries, don't forget, this is a general reading, will not resonate for everyone, but keep what does and leave the rest. You've got two cards coming out. You've got Six of Swords energy and the Judgment card. So with this intuition thrown into the mix, with this balancing of knowledge and wisdom, harmony and insight on things, there's also a moment of judgment. Now, this could be you judging, not judging yourself too harshly, right? Being too self-critical on a situation. Or it could also be making a judgment call in a sense. It could also have to do with how you are judged by others as much as how you yourself judge others. It's really interesting, though, and the pieces are starting to come together a little bit more here because of the Six of Swords energy. Six of Swords is the energy of recuperation, but it's the recuperation with assistance of others, usually. Could also mean you're traveling, relocating, or just kind of like taking a mental break from it all and perhaps seeking some counsel on something as well. Again, if you're making choices, if you're going with your intuition, you may find yourself, okay, it's time to leave this situation, right? It's an ending. Maybe you're not seeing the rewards you had hoped for, and you're like, okay, I may need some help kind of moving forward from this. Maybe there's a judgment that's been made for some of you, but you may need some help going forward with this. But it's really a time to relax, to really let go and let somebody else do the driving. Especially if you're going with your gut, that'll definitely be more present and available to you. So be on the lookout for a helping hand, a helping friend, because it really is your time to kind of relax and recover and before you go moving forward, because you do have, again, this profound decision that's being made, and you have Temperance card out now. Could be dealing with a Sagittarius, could be dealing with something that's requiring moderation, patience for sure, faith in a situation. Yes, tap into that divine energy. Ask your ancestors about this one for sure. Could also be dealing with some sort of alcoholism involved, perhaps with an individual. So it's kind of like a mixed bag of things here for you, Aries, where, you know, some of you, okay, it's over, I'm moving on, I'm going with my gut, I've chosen this or that someone. It could be that relationship taking time, yes. And then there's this element of finance, and like, okay, maybe some sort of financial things either coming to an end, or you're choosing for it to come to an end because of that Lover's card energy out there. That's a judgment you make, you go with your gut, and then it's like, okay, I need a little bit of help here to kind of rest, recover from whatever situation you've been in. Again, moderation is the key. Having patience in the situation, having faith in the situation for sure here, Aries, as something comes to an end. So we'll take a look, see what else Spirit wants you to know with the Archangel deck. You know what else is going on for Aries, please? Can I have a message for Aries, please, Spirit? What else would you like Aries to know for March 21st to 28th? Clairaudience is this card. It says, notice the loving guidance you hear inside your mind or from other people. Loving guidance is the key to this. We want it loving energy, warm energy. Again, you're loving from others. The Six of Swords, traveling those emotional seas, but you're not going it alone. Let's see what else. Here we go. Goddess deck, please. Is there anything else we'd like to offer Aries for the week of March 28th through the 21st? Please, Goddess deck. Thank you. Okay, we've got home. Your household situation is improving, either through a move, right, or healthy change. That could be that ending in the occupants. So blessed be. And there you have it, Aries. Let me know what you think in the comments below. And hey, guys, don't forget to like and subscribe. Take care. I'll see you soon.